I found what the hot trends of 2020 will be.
Oh, this is a predictive. This is the thing that's going to be. Cassettes will make a comeback.
No, these are they're more specific than that. They're parenting trends.
Ugh. Cocaine's making a comeback.
No, parenting trends.
Oh, parenting, not cocaine.
Parenting with cocaine. So what are some parenting?
This is done by a poll. It's a poll over in the UK, which we love UK polls because they are just the best at polls.
They're very good at being British.
One of them's called, so parenting trends will be, one's called the Greta effect.
I think it's something environmental.
Yeah, Greta Thunberg. They're saying that more kids will be getting into activism.
Ah, gotcha.
Which is okay, fine, whatever.
Okay, good. Yeah, you know, teaching about the planet, that's fine.
Family gaming. Spending more time playing games.
There you go.
Instead of sitting there watching TV, you know, put the phones away, maybe do some family time, right?
And what's a little Madden for you, something like that.
The anti-natalist movement, a rather scary sounding way to describe the choice to not have children for the sake of saving the planet. Oh, okay. So to kind of lower the exploding population. Okay, good luck. Tell the third world that.
Apparently another parenting trend of the new year will be there's a lot of eco moms out there. They're going to go back to natural birth. No painkillers, no scans, no nothing. Just the way they did it in a grass hut.
Oh, nice.
Oh, it hurts so bad! Oh!
Another parenting trend is plastic-free, trying to go plastic-free. Every day, take 20 minutes, set aside, sit with your children, talk to your children. Micro-scheduling, which is scheduling everything down to a minute, which sounds like a ton of fun.
That sounds insane.
That sounds like a ton of fun.
Pure insanity.
That sounds like a way to go crazy.
That's just OCD. That's just someone that's...
And then the final one.
Okay.
The parenting trend of 2020 is going to be period parties.
Excuse me?
Period parties.
Hold on. I'm sorry. You're going to have to describe what that is.
Well, it's a celebration of a girl's entrance into womanhood, Justin.
Like,
you have a party.
Like, hiring a...
This is going to be, they already exist, apparently, but, 2020, they're going to be, it's going to come on real strong.
Hi, I'm Bleedy, the clown!
It's going to be the new, new gender reveal party. In 2020, it's going to be the period party.
It's going to
so
be
like, when you're 16 and you are a woman and you have a party or a bar mitzvah, something like that, except...
It's going to be, it's the first time you menstruate. You have a big party.
Shed
period.
Your lining.
It's called a period party.
Oh, God.
This is a thing.
It's
a thing someone's trying to make happen.
It says they already exist.
My
article says they already exist.
Yeah, well, there's underground Seattle horse parties. I don't think that they're going to turn that into a nationwide bit. I feel like this is just going to be a couple of people with NPR tote bags really trying to make this thing happen. I can only assume these people have a lot of hot takes about films. I'm not a woman. As badly as I desperately wish I would wake up every day as one, I don't know this. I don't know this life. I don't get this. But we do have Dawn, and we do have Misha, and this was something that you experienced at one point.
Is it something that should be celebrated? I mean, why not celebrate? You're becoming a woman, right? Is this...
No.
No?
Hey, Dad, check it out!
So. I'm trying to be forward-thinking. I'm trying to be open-minded here. I could be the closed-minded... you know, toxic male of the room and be like, hey, you know, periods are gross. Why would you celebrate that? It's disgusting.
They're dangerous.
What bleeds for a week and doesn't die.
I read somewhere that their periods attract bears.
No, but why not celebrate it? Why not? Why not?
I would say more so people can have sympathy to understand what you're going through, that it feels like you have a knife in your stomach that's being turned around for a week.
So why not have a sheet cake for that? You know, why not inflate some balloons? Okay, I get removing the shame.
Yeah, right. That's there we go.
But do I need to, like, have all the relatives over? Like, guess who's got to go tampon shopping?
It's going to your house,
No, Misha, let's, as much as you want to tell us or not, when that moment in your life happened, was it something that you wanted to just gather the family around the hearth and say, I've got some news?
Yeah, was there an announcement? Like, is there an announcement or how's that work?
No, that was, first of all, I was, I guess, like 14 and
it's a private thing.
Very private, very exceedingly private.
Okay.
I didn't want my dad to know. And my mom was like, well, we have to tell him. I was like, do we?
Do we need to bring it up to him?
Yes, Dad needs to know.
No.
He's going to need to know at some point, but you got to let him know immediately.
Yeah, no. And then to let like the whole family know. And
I don't think Dad needs to know.
He does. He's got to know what's going on with his daughters.
I got a daughter. What are you talking about? I need to know everything about her. Yeah. I need to know if that's happening. I need to know if I need to run to the store. I need to know if there's an emergency, what I need to do.
Yeah, did you become a woman or did you sit on a steak knife? What's going on with the laundry? You have to know. So if you go to shop, you might pick up some things from the feminine hygiene aisle.
You would pick up stuff for your daughter?
If I had to, that's my homegirl, of course. I got her back no matter what.
Well, can't you just find out when she comes to ask you to pick up from the store?
Well, yeah, but it doesn't matter when you find out at that point. It's like, hey, just by the way, earlier this week,
Ooh, Angela,
our daughter got her period.
Hey, just letting you know.
Yeah.
Like a quiet in the hallway.
I just wanted to let you know.
I'd rather that than be like,
guess what?
I gotta run to the store.
I want a cake and a clown and I want presents and I want a big blood red nightgown. I don't know what to do for a part. What does the party entail?
Yeah, what does the cake look like?
Do you have like fun, like red velvet cupcakes?
Cherry flavored.
Oh, there we go.
I'm just asking. And if you just Google parenting trends 2020, you'll see one of the ones right there, like in the top 10 are period parties.
It's the celebration of a young woman becoming just that. A woman.
It's something I didn't even know existed. And then come to find out, our good friend Bert Kreischer, he has a whole bit about it that he does. And he talked about it on Conan O'Brien.
Yeah, here we are. This is Conan talking about his Bert Kreischer's period party with his daughters.
She was like, I need you to go to the store.
See?
And get supplies. I'm throwing a period party tonight. You never heard of this?
A period party?
You never heard of this?
I've never heard of that.
Dude, this is real. She goes, Dad, I'm throwing a period party. I'm like, yo, I'm like, what's that? She goes, I need you to go to the store and get a red velvet cake. I'm like,
see?
Dude, all the girls are throwing them, Dad. Red velvet cake and icing so we can name my period.
What?
That's what I said. I go, who names their period?
All right, so Misha and Dawn, do either one of you have a name for your monthly visitor?
No.
The Crimson Viper?
I never thought to name that.
No? The Cherry Demon? Nothing?
Ew. Yeah, that would be accurate, though.
The Blood Red Curse? Crimson Moon? Something? Misha, you told us about yours, It was just sort of a private moment. You and Mom didn't really want to tell Dad. Had to tell him at some point. Dawn, yours in your house, was it sort of one of those things where you're like, all right, well, here we go. I got to tell Mom. Who'd you tell first?
I told my mom. She got all emotional.
Yeah.
I was 12. She started crying. And she goes, oh, you're a woman now. Oh, my gosh. And she was prepared for it and had gone out like 2 years before and went to BJ's and bought a whole thing of like pads and
got like two necessaries.
You got 2-year-old pads?
I mean, they're still good. You can still use them.
She was really planning ahead.
Any day now.
That is what it was like.
Yeah.
Was she excited more than anything else?
She was excited and then emotional because I was a woman now. But she never thought about
like bringing in a petting zoo and having a pin the period pad on the ovaries game on the wall.
And she wanted to make sure that I knew what it was because back in her day, it wasn't really talked about.
Yeah, yeah.
And her mom told her the babies came from the stork, and my mom got her period at 10, and she thought she was bleeding to death.
She thought she was going to die. She didn't even know.
How great were the 50s, man, when they just ignored everything.
Yeah.
They just shoved it all down inside, and everyone had a heart attack at the age of 45. 410-338-1098. Let's go to the phones. We have our friend Tim been patiently holding. Tim, good morning.
Good morning, boys.
How you doing, man?
Hey.
So my whole thing about this is the period party sounds like an evolved celebration of a more archaic celebration in a sense where it's like you think about how things like Christmas and Halloween used to be, more sacred celebrations, and now they're just very bastardized and they're just very commercial things. I feel like the period party could have very well been something that was highly regarded. It's like this is a woman's or young girl's transition to womanhood, and this you know, and it was probably something very sacred and highly regarded. And now,
like, you hear me talk about the quinceañera, which is it's basically marking a woman's a girl's passage from girl into woman. Is it a branding issue here that we're calling it a period party? Like, I feel like the branding, like you say quinceañera and no one starts retching.
Well,
you say
no, period party. I think it actually has to do, quinceañera is like, somebody was saying, you know, the cleaned up version of this is the Sweet 16.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
That's becoming a woman, but I think this is, you know, a more biological, real.
Yeah, if you called it like a becoming a woman party or something, yeah. I feel that would have a better connotation.
A woman celebration, something, but then doing the whole red balloons, velvet sheet cake.
I bet he's right. If you go back to, you know, like tribal times or wherever it was, you know, they do celebrate things like this. When a woman menstruates, they'll probably pray to some god that she's become a woman and now she's fertile and the tribe can live on, and they have a big, they probably did have period parties.
You can kind of see that.
Or like Josh's news from, if you leave March or April, they send you into a hut to live for 7 days on the outskirts of town, and they let the dog eat first before you get to, which is why Los Estados Unidos, USA, USA until the end of time. There was a whole thing about people in like certain Middle Eastern countries, I believe India, the outskirts of Pakistan. These poor girls would have their periods on like the 13th, 14th, whatever, and then they'd just be sent out into the brush to live because they thought it was some horrible blood moon curse that was about to befall the village and the crops would fail.
And they couldn't go to school. They couldn't do anything.
They make them live in a hut, like a clay hut. That's disgusting. Now, Misha, being that you didn't have one, would you like us to maybe...
She didn't have a period?
You didn't have a period yet.
Oh, no, party.
Party.
Oh,
party. Period, party. We would be more than willing to... We did a second chance prom yet. We'd like to throw you maybe sort of a... Now that you're in your early to mid-20s, we'd like to have you maybe have one. We could rent the Jimmy's upstairs. We could have some nice gazpacho. We could... Like a lot of various types of salsas. Oh. I'm trying to figure out the menu here.
Some spaghetti.
Oh, God.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.